In this video, we will rebuild a $500,000 a month app in under 20 minutes using Lovable and N8N. It's all no code, super easy, and after this tutorial, you also will be able to create any app you like. But let me first show you a short demo. Here on the right, we have GPT-0 that can tell you in seconds if this text is AI generated or not. Let's try it out. And I click scan here. And like you can see, this text was directly detected as AI generated. Now let's take this text and paste it in the app we will rebuild today. This app was created with Lovable and N8N. Let's paste here the text and click humanize text. Now we wait a little. And now we copy and paste the new text here and click again scan. And like you can see, GPT-0 cannot detect it as AI generated anymore. It sounds like a human. And we will now build this app from scratch. And make sure to stick until the end, because I'm going to leak the distribution strategy they use to acquire customers. I'll show you exactly how they hijacked the algorithm to print 500k a month with zero ad spend. By the way, if you like this video, make sure also to check out my other video where I rebuilt a $12 million app in 20 minutes with no code. And don't forget to drop a comment to tell me which app to rebuild next. But first, I will give you a short overview how this whole thing works. So this whole website we will build with Lovable. It's a no-code platform where the whole website is created just with prompts. All prompts that are needed for this tutorial I will provide in the description box below for free. After we prompted Lovable, we will have a beautiful website. But the problem is, it just looks beautiful and won't work. For this website to work, we will connect it with N8N. It's a no-code platform, everything is drag and drop, and it's super easy to use. And it allows you to connect any app you like. The user pastes in here the text. This text is then sent to N8N. He will process the AI generated text and make it humanized. And then we will send this answer back to Lovable and we will see the results directly there. So it's pretty simple. The Lovable website sends the request to N8N and N8N sends the answer back to Lovable. And without further ado, let's get started. In case you don't know me yet, I'm Ed. I help beginners and business owners to get started with AI and AI automation. In my school community, we take you from an absolute beginner to an advanced user. Here you will get all templates and instructions needed to create high leverage AI agents like the voice agent or RAG agents or content automations like the clipping automation and the auto publishing automation and many more. So make sure to join the community if you're serious about learning about AI and AI automation. So make sure to open up the instructions to follow along. Here you can also find the N8N workflow that you can simply import in N8N by clicking create workflow and then importing this file. It's that simple. First, we open up Lovable. If you don't have an account yet, click Get Started. Once you're logged in, you should see this screen. Then go to the instructions and copy and paste this following prompt into Lovable and click Start. Now Lovable will create our website. This usually takes a few seconds. All right, Lovable created now our website here. But the problem is I don't like the design yet. So I take first a screenshot of it. Then I open up ChatGPT, drag and drop that screenshot into ChatGPT. And then copy and paste a simple prompt into ChatGPT and send this message. Now ChatGPT gave us a list with improvements that we can simply copy and paste to Lovable. Just remove here the last sentence and send it off to Lovable. Now Lovable will adjust this website for us. Lovable just finished and like you can see, the website looks already much, much better. It even has pricing here and so on. The only thing I don't like is that it's dark design. So I will change it. Make it light design and send it off. Amazing, we have now a beautiful website here. But the problem is it just looks beautiful. For example, when we take this text here now and click humanize text, we see that it's working and it even gives us an output. But this output is basically the same what we give as an input. So if I would take this output here now and now we paste this to GPT-0 and click scan, you will see that it detected it as AI generated. To fix that, we need N8N. If you don't have an account yet, click get started, otherwise sign in. Once you're signed in, click create workflow. Then go to the instructions back and download the N8N workflow template. Then you can simply import the file here. Then you need to go to this website and create an account. Once you got that, you go to this page here and copy this API key and paste it here. Then you go back to the canvas and click save. Then you click here publish and click here publish again. Once done that, you go here to settings and activate here MCP and click save. And we're almost finished. By the way, in a minute, I will show you exactly how I created this workflow from scratch. Now we go back to Lovable, then click here the plus icon, go to connectors and click here manage connectors. Here under personal connectors, we select N8N and click here setup. Then we click here connect. And here we need to provide a server URL. For that, you go back to N8N, go here to settings and click MCP access. You first activate it here, and then you simply copy the server URL here and paste it into Lovable and click add and authorize. Then a pop-up appears here, and here you click allow. Now we connected NLN and Lovable. And from now on, it's pretty simple. But we just instruct Lovable to use this workflow here, this one. We just copy the name here and go to Lovable and say connect the N8N workflow with this app. And then we send off this message. Now Lovable will access this workflow and detect what the inputs and the outputs are to adjust this website here to work. Lovable will ask you for access. You can click here allow, allow here again. All right, Lovable just finished and it said it connected to the workflow here. But let's try it out if it works. We click now again humanize text. And now we copy this output here and paste it into GPT-0 and click scan. And like you can see, it's now 100% human. When we go to our workflow and click here on executions, you will see here the list of executions. So for example, when I would click here again, humanize text, I did it just now, then we will see the new execution here in a minute. And like you can see, it just appeared here. All right, and now I will show you how to build this from scratch. For this, you go to your NLN and click create workflow. First, we add our first trigger. For that, we choose for the beginning on form submission. This enables us to quickly test our workflow first. Let's give it a title like tag humanizer and add a form element. Let's call it text to humanize. And as element type, we select text area. When we click now execute step, a pop-up appears now where we can give a text to humanize. Let's take any random text here from ChatGPT and paste it here and click submit. Like you can see, we receive this text here in our NLN and we can now work with it and humanize it. First we go back to Canvas and pin this node here by selecting pin and then click save. First we need to sanitize the input. For that we search for edit fields and select edit fields node here and add the field here. Let's call it text to humanize and drag and drop this element here and then click execute step and let's rename this node to text to humanize. From now on we will always use this variable from this node. This will enable us to replace this form element with a webhook quickly, and a webhook is needed so Lovable can communicate with our workflow. Next we need access to undetectable AI because we're using this service to humanize our text. To authorize ourselves with this service, for that we go back to our instructions and copy and paste this curl snippet here that you can find under get short-lived access. Then you go back to our workflow, click here the plus icon and search for HTTP and select HTTP request. Then you click import curl, paste the snippet here and click import. And here you need to provide the master API key. For that you open up this page here and copy this key here and paste it here. Then you go back to the instructions, copy the node name and paste it here. Then we go back to Canvas and click save. And then click execute step. Here we will receive a short-lived token that expires in a few seconds. But since it's automatic now, we don't have to worry about it much. Then we go back to Canvas and click again the plus icon. Type in HTTP and select HTTP request. Then we go back to our instructions. Copy this curl snippet here and I create humanized text. Then go back, click import curl. Paste the snippet here, click import, and here we need to provide an API key or token. For that we remove this one here, click here expression, and then drag and drop the expression token from the get short-lived access node. Then we continue scrolling down here, and here we have to provide our content text that we need to humanize. It's here. For that we replace the text that is currently there, click here expression, then open the text to humanize node, and drag and drop this variable here. Then you scroll down here. Here you can set up things like the readability, for example, high school or college or university. Then you can here select the purpose, for example, general writing. And you can also set up the strength, for example, to be more human or to be more accurate. Once you've done that, you click here execute step. Then you receive the message document submitted successfully. The last thing we have to do is we go back to our instructions and copy the node name, rename our node, and go back to Canvas and click save. Our submitted text to humanize, we need now to get it. For that we click again the plus icon here and type in HTTP, select HTTP request, go back to our instructions and copy this snippet here under get humanized text and paste it here and click import. Here again we have to provide our API key, so we delete the placeholder, click here expression, and then under short-lived access we drag and drop this variable here. Then we scroll down here, and we need also to write a document ID. For that, we remove this placeholder, click here expression, and drag and drop the variable ID under create humanized text here, and click execute step. And like you can see, we have the input and the output. So if I copy this and paste it into GPT-0 and click scan, boom, look at that. In just a few minutes, we just bypassed the most advanced AI detector on the market. Now we just need to feed it back to the app. Let's go back to NLN, then go back to our instructions, copy the node name here, go back, rename the node, and close the node and click save. Let's reload our workflow here and click here again, execute workflow. What you will notice now when we open up now the get humanized text is that the output is empty. It's because it's still processing. That's why we need to add here an if node that will first check if this output is not empty. For that, you select here under string exist and click execute step. So as long as the output does not exist, it will go here with the false branch. What we want to do in this case is then to wait. So we select here the wait node, select for example 5 seconds, and then to recheck again. And this will loop until it's finished. Then we go to the true branch. Let's click save here and select again execute workflow. And like you can see now, it's looping here true until it's finished. And it's finished already. Now we click here the plus icon, select here edit fields to sanitize the output. Click here add field, give it the name like humanized text, and drag and drop the output here. And click execute step. Now let's go back to canvas, click save, give this workflow a name like text humanizer. And that's it. So when we compare now our workflow we just created with the template, we see the only difference is the trigger here. So the last step we have to do is to click here the plus icon, select add another trigger, then select on webhook call. Here you change the HTTP method to post and give it the path like text humanizer. Close it here again, then drag and drop it here and connect it with this text to humanize node. Then you can remove the form submission node here. Double click on this text to humanize node. Then you go back to the instructions. Copy this snippet and paste it here. And that's it. In case you're wondering how I created curl commands, make sure to join my school community. There I have a short tutorial how to create them easily with ChatGPT. It's really simple. And now let's talk about the business strategy. How did they scale this app in 30 days to 1 million ARR? Okay, so the UI looks nice and the app is working. But here's the hard truth. A pretty app sitting on your laptop makes exactly $0. You need users. That's why we will have a closer look at the Frankenstein method they used to scale this app. So how exactly did he do that? He didn't create a new wave. He hijacked it. The founder calls this method Frankenstein method. Or to be more precise, this is what the founder said.
I was like the solo UGC creator, kind of faceless founder-led style content. But in about 30 days, we hit 1 million ARR, did 500K in a month.
So they used an organic marketing strategy to scale the app to 500K MRR in just 30 days. Let's look closer into it. So the Frankenstein method is pretty easy. You take existing viral content and take the first few seconds of them. And then after that content, you push your own content. Let me show you in a short example. Check out this video.
How are you using ChatGPT for the last essay? So guess what? Your final essay is now 50 pages.
50 pages? Try 100 for my friend.
And like you can see, the first few seconds were from a viral video, and the rest of the video is then a cut that they created that matches perfectly the team and the target audience. That's why it's so important to have a really good positioning when you're using this technique. Here in this case, it was pretty easy. The positioning was in this case us versus them. Us students against a system that is not working correctly, or what kind of system it is that you have to do assignments that an AI chatbot can easily fulfill. So it's like an us versus them. And it's like this low quality footage that looks really organic, that does not feel like marketing. And he combined all these three strategies to one viral strategy that made them literally millions. And it was this particular video that blew up across multiple platforms.
And so I basically merged those clips together. And that one video did well over 100 million, 150 million views across platforms. And by the end of the day, that video on the TikTok account alone is at like 15 or 16 million views. And then they started getting reposted on X by random.
And after that, they sold the whole company. So the key insights is it's mostly organic. They used emotional content that drives shareability, and they use an authentic approach that beats polished content. And the best part is you can copy all this without building a personal brand first. So this is how you can win. In the old world, you had to suffer through 90 days of coding before you could even start the marketing. By the launch day, you were exhausted. But because you use Lovable and NNN to build this tool in 20 minutes, you have flipped the equation. You now have a 90-day head start to focus purely on the marketing strategy and finding a cult that already exists that you can hijack with the Frankenstein method. While your competition is still debugging, you're dominating the attention. Speed is not just nice to have, it's your only superpower. So stop guessing, start automating. So accelerate the building part with NNN and Lovable, and use social media automations to go viral faster. So the content machine brings you the traffic, and the NNN workflow with Lovable captures the cache, and you need both. Here you can use viral video generators, or a UGC content machine that creates UGC content on autopilot, or an auto-publishing agent that publishes content on autopilot, so you never forget the post. And on the other side, you can leverage AI with NNN and Lovable to create the products fast. So make sure to join my school community if you're really serious about AI and AI automation and want to make money with it. So don't waste time guessing, download the systems, deploy the agents, and automate your way to win. Let's see you inside.